What's good, everybody? It's your boy 313 J-Mo. I got a quick video for you guys. My man Sadiq Bey, 6 threes in the first quarter, absolutely balling out of his mother effing mind. I mean, just completely going crazy in that first quarter. He cooled off throughout the game, on the ended up with 2 points in the second half. But we needed that jolt to get the lead. This man Sadiq Bey is gonna be a special player. I'm talking Paul George, Jaylen Brown type potential. Yeah, I said it. I feel it. That's just how I feel. This kid gonna keep getting better. He gonna be a special kid. He can end up being the number one player on this team. If he gets his dribbling, that's all he needs. If he get that dribbling and handle game down, I mean, this dude is truly gonna be special. But besides that, Isaiah Stewart balled out. He cooked Jared Allen. And it's good that he did that, because Jared Allen kind of gave him work the last time they played. Stewart finished with 18-16. Another monstrous double-double. Man, he had 19-12 the last game. Shout out to what he did the last game and the game before. And my man Killer Kill with the pass that had everybody put on notice. The whole league saw it. You know, everybody was posting it. I didn't drop a video. I did the live stream about it. But my man Killian balled out once again tonight. We're going to get to him. But we're going to get back to my man Stewart. Stewart balled out completely, man. This man destroyed Jared Allen. Cooked him. 5-5 was monster. He even had that clutch basket with the Killian lob. And then he had another basket where he took it right into, it was like Hartenstein chest, I think it was, and just scored, man. Stewart's going to be a player, man. We know this, but we continuously to see it. I wanted this man to start after the way he was been playing, like, and he started. But when Plumlee comes back, he needs to be starting. When Corey Joseph comes back, Killian need to be starting. I don't want no baby hands or no kid gloves. Let these young guys play. Let these young guys run. And I know a lot of Pistons fans want us to lose games, but y'all need to get over it. We got some damn good players this year. We're not going to be a top two worst team. We drafted too well. Be salty about it. These young kids, and you know, Josh Jackson and the Diallos of the world and the Frank Jacksons of the world, these young kids, they out to win games and proving themselves. So you're just going to have to ride with the wave. Troy Weaver, no, I'm trying to tell you, as long as we got a top five pick, Troy Weaver is going to get a stud. Look what he did. He got Killian at 7. He got Stewart at 14. I think Bay at like 17 or 18. Got Saban. Bro, trust in Troy. He's going to draft a great player. So instead of worrying about fading for K or tanking for some all-time great, look, we can still draft an all-time great with Troy Weaver at the helm. That's all I'm saying, because I'm starting to see the future. Pistons are probably going to win a few more games and keep us out of the top two. And I'm just trying to prepare y'all for the inedible. I mean, for the inevitable, not in the inedible. That's funny. But look, on to my main man. You see the pass, Killer Kill, as I call my man. Stop playing with this boy. Once again, putting on a passing clinic. And I had told people, Sadiq Bey struggled so much without his point guard out there to set him up. Like, when Killian wasn't playing, he'll be all right. He'll be inconsistent. But when you had that guy out there setting you up and then he's just gone, things are just different. Shots seem a little bit tougher. You know, shots seem a little bit harder. Man, as soon as he got out there, of course, Sadiq Bey got some buckets on his own. The boy is nice. But Killian is setting him up for just easy passes, just finding him and Josh Jackson. Like, some of the times when Josh Jackson and these boys receive the ball, you can literally see in their eyes, they're like, oh, I got the ball. As in, I didn't know it was going to be in my hands, and it already is. Oh, I got the ball, and I'm open. Even when Josh Jackson was making those clutch shots, Killian just handed him the ball. That's one thing I like about guards like Killian and Chris Paul and my boy Lonzo. They do the simplest plays, but to you it looks simple, but it's 100% the right play. To you it just looked like he just walked up to Josh Jackson and just handed him the ball and just moved out the way. That's not what happened. But see, y'all don't think like that. At some point guard, they do the simplest thing just to get you a position to do what you're great at. And that's what Killian's been doing. I'm not going to forget Ray Jackson balled his ass out today. Balled out. I'm going to give him respect, man. He played very, extremely well. Wish he was better on defense, though. But, hey, man, if you're going to give up points, you better be scoring some points. And he played very great. hit a clutch basket at the end of the game. Killian turned it up in the second half. 9 assists, 12 points, 5 of 8 from the field for the haters, man. This kid's getting better every game, even though it's only 12 measly-ass points, career high. I don't care. This boy gonna be nice. Sadiq Bey gonna be nice. Stewart gonna be nice. And as much as y'all detractors hate on Sekou, he gonna be nice too. We got a very, very bright future, and I'm just happy for the Pistons. And at the end of the day, I never want my team to lose, man. And to all the Pistons fans that want that top two pick and they crying about it, put it like this. If Killian played the whole season, whether or not how bad he played at the beginning in some of your eyes, where y'all forget the three good games he played in 07, but we ain't gonna get to that. But we'll be winning more games. You don't draft a guy 7th overall to be picking again in the top two. You don't draft Sadiq Bey. You don't draft 3 first round picks and be expecting to pick in the top two, y'all. I'm just giving y'all the reality of the situation. And if these young guys are as good as we project them to be, we should not be a top two pick. I hate to say it, but I'm showing y'all and they showing y'all by winning these damn games. Look, we a little bit better than getting the Cade Cunningham. That's just not going to happen. We're going to get somebody else to help us because we just a little bit better. And at the end of the day, it's okay because we could still end up with the number one in the lottery is. But considering all the assets we attained, we shouldn't be the worst team. We should be, you know, where we about to be. Maybe that 4 or 3 spot, maybe even 5. We'll see how many games they win. But I don't care what y'all say, even if we didn't want this win, this is a good win for the damn Pistons and the Young Guns for the second, third game, because really they did it with OKC the first time. But once again, Killer Kill, floor general, elevating everybody around him, Frank Jackson coming off the bench, hitting some buckets, Stewart being a monster, Sadiq Bey balling out, Josh Jackson doing his thing. Pistons beat the Cavs, Killer Kill, balling out, 9 assists. Let me know what you think about the game, man. What's your thoughts on Sadiq Bey, Stewart, Killian, and Jackson, and the others?